In this video, we'll be looking at the problem of finding the area of a surface generated by rotating a curve about the y-axis. So let's think about this problem in general before we look at our particular example. So the idea is I have some sort of curve here that I want to rotate about the y-axis. So I think about splitting up my interval into lots of little subintervals. So I'm thinking about little line segments like this being rotated about the y-axis and having these little bands whose areas I would be adding up. But now we look at the fact that the radius of one of these little bands here, instead of being equal to some sort of height f of x, is going to be a horizontal radius here. So it will be equal to our function g of y. So if this function here is x equals g of y, then my radius piece is g of y minus 0, the y-axis, which is x equals 0. And then again, I'll have some sort of length of that little line segment. So here, I'm thinking about the general formula for surface area for a curve rotated about the y-axis as an integral from c to d of 2 pi times my radius, which now is g of y, times my length, which in terms of y is going to be 1 plus g prime of y squared under the square root, and then we have dy. Okay, so we'll look at this for our particular example now. We're given a curve, y equals 3x to the 1/3, and we're asked to rotate that curve for the interval where x is between 0 and 8/3 about the y-axis. Okay, but we've seen that when we go about writing down our surface area formula for a rotation about the y-axis, we're going to want to integrate with respect to y. So we're going to have our surface area be an integral over our y bounds. So notice that, if x is 0 here, y would also be equal to 0 if we have 3x to the 1/3. And when I have x is equal to 8/3, I'm going to have y is equal to 3 times 8/3 to the 1/3. So it looks like my y will be the cube root of 8, or y will be 2. So I'll be looking at bounds here from 0 to 2 for my y bounds. I'll have 2 pi times my function in terms of y. So notice that I'm going to have y cubed is equal to 3x. If I look at taking the third power of both sides, and then I'll have x is equal to y cubed over 3. Okay, so I'm going to have this 0 to 2, 2 pi y cubed over 3 times the square root of 1 plus my derivative here, dx dy squared. So I'll have 3y squared over 3 squared dy. Okay, if I want to use this version here of finding my surface area about the y-axis and integrating with respect to y. So let's look at how we can simplify this. I didn't go through and do the multiple steps like we've done before with first finding the derivative squared, and then adding 1, because it's not too messy in this particular case, but we know that sometimes it's helpful for us to go through and do those steps separately. So here we have this integral from 0 to 2 of 2 pi y cubed over 3, and we have the square root of 1 plus y to the 4th dy. Okay, so notice that the technique that we're going to need here is going to be a little bit different than a lot of the other problems that we've seen before. We're not going to try to rewrite 1 plus y to the 4th as some sort of thing squared, but I notice that I have something with a y to the 4th under the square root, and I have some sort of y cubed on the outside. So the technique that we need to use here is to use u substitution. So we're going to let u be equal to 1 plus y to the 4th. So our du is 4y cubed dy. So we have 1/4 du is y cubed dy. Okay, so we've got our integral now of 2 pi. I have that y cubed over 3 here, but the y cubed dy part is going to be replaced by 1/4. It may also help here, before we go about rewriting this in terms of u, to pull out any constants. So I have this 2/3 pi or 2 pi thirds that I can pull out in front of my integral. The y cubed dy can become my 1/4 du. And this square root of 1 plus y to the 4th is going to become my square root of u. Okay. I also need to remember to change to my u limits. Okay, so before we had limits from y equals 0 to y equals 2. Now we're going to have limits from u equals 1 plus 0, or 1, to u equals 1 plus 2 to the 4th. So that's going to be 217. Okay, so remember u of 0 is going to be 1, and then we're going to have u of 2, which is 1 plus 2 to the 4th. That's how we get that upper bound of 17. So now we're ready to go ahead and integrate this. So again, I can pull this constant out in front. So I'm going to have, 2 pi over 12, or just pi over 6 out in front. We have this integral from 1 to 17 of u to the 1/2 du. So that's going to become, with my antiderivative, u to the 3/2 divided by 3/2, or times 2/3, from 1 to 17. Remember, since we did a u substitution, and we had our integrand here in terms of u, and our bounds in terms of u, I don't have to go back to y at all. Everything's all in terms of the same variable. So I have 2 pi over 18 here, or pi over 9, times 17 to the 3/2 minus 1. Okay. And we can't simplify that anymore, so that's what we would leave as our surface area for this example.